Yes guys, so let's read the 34. Draft balance sheet of WHO, three companies, 2012 is as under. As of fixed asset, check the investments. W holds investments in shares of H and also in shares of O. He has 80,000 shares in O. If you observe, are 200 and 200 each. That means if each share is 1 rupee and everything is in thousands, so that means there are 2 lakh shares. 2 lakh shares of H Limited, out of which 1 lakh 60 are held by W. That means 80%. So that is H is a subsidiary for you. Now come to O. 80,000 shares in O, out of total 2 lakhs, he holds 40%. 40% is not controlling interest. He cannot be called as a subsidiary, so it should be called as an associate there. W purchased shares in H on 13th October 2. O Limited on 11/5/07 when the balance of the reserve was 242. The following dividend were declared but not accounted for before the year end. So from the current year profits we need to make sure that the dividends are declared on and actually deducted. 65, 30 and 15. Included in the inventory of O is inventory valued at 20,000, which has been purchased from W at a cost. Guys, whose company? Inventory of O. O is what? O is an associate. Associate, I don't even consolidate. I don't even add the assets and liabilities. So I do not have any adjustment relating to intercompany owings or intercompany transactions. So point number D is useless. I won't even consider that since it is an associate. Point number E, goodwill in respect of H is completely written off. So I should reduce it in cost of control and also in your reserves for CBS. On 31st March, H Limited paid a bonus of 1 share for every share held. This has not been accounted for on the balance sheet date. This is also not accounted for. You need to account for the bonus. Whenever bonus is declared, bonus should always be declared from pre-acquisition. Dividend. D and G are completely useless for me. I don't even consider these 2 points. But unlike the previous 2 questions, we need to solve for the analysis of reserves here because there's a dividend adjustment as well as a bonus adjustment here. So let's start. Start as usual with your date of acquisition. Two acquisitions, W in H and in O on 11th May 2007. Shareholding patterns. Number of shares and percentage holding. First, in H. On the asset side, I see 1,60,000 shares in H held by W and the total number of shares in W are 2 lakhs. But read the point number F. On 31st March, H Limited paid a bonus issue of 1 share for every share held. This is not accounted for. That means this share capital is also pre-bonus. We have to give an adjustment for bonus even here. So let's try to write down. pre-bonus, bonus and post-bonus. Let's start. In H Limited, before bonus, 1,60,000 shares. Total number of shares before bonus are 2 lakhs. If you want, you can reduce it to thousands. That would make sense because everything is in thousands. So let me reduce it to 1,000. 160. If I am reducing it to thousands, total number of shares pre-bonus at 200. That 40. What is the bonus component? Read point number F. Bonus is made at the rate of 1 share for every share held. That means the bonus is 1:1. AT20 is your shareholding pattern. In associate O, W holds the number of shares held, 80,000 shares. 80 accounts for 40%. That's it. You can't write minority interest or anything in this. Let's try to frame up your analysis of reserves. Here I need analysis. Date of acquisition, the first analysis. Let's start considering H Limited. Balance as on 31st March 2012, 850. Split. Balance on date of acquisition. Balance as on, what is my date of acquisition in H? 13th October 2007. On that day, the balance of the reserve was 500. So what are the profits post acquisition? Profit post my acquisition is 350. I have two adjustments. One for bonus, one for dividend. Bonus out of pre-acquisition, dividend out of post acquisition. Less bonus. Bonus is 200. Check your shareholding pattern. We have already written the value of bonus. Balance left out is 300, that is pre-acquisition reserves. From this 350, you need to deduct the dividend. H Limited dividend is point number C, 30. $320 being post acquisition then. I don't need a separate distribution table. You can directly distribute it here as 80-20. So W and minority. $80-20 is out of 300 is 240 and 60. This is 256 and 64. Similarly, you can solve even for O. Analysis for O Limited. Reserve. Balance as on 31st March 2012. Balance sheet date reserve balance is 478. Split balance as on 1st April, sorry, date of acquisition guys, 11507. On the date of acquisition it was 242. Profits post acquisition should be then the balance of 236. Out of this, O declares a dividend of 15. He did not pay it, he is only proposing it. Oh, this 242 is pre-acquisition. 221 is post acquisition. Split W, only W share because it is an associate, 40%. Only W share, this is 88.4. This is 96.8. Information sufficient for us to draft cost of control. W in holding company, W in H in subsidiary, W in O associate. Cost of investment, check the asset side. W in H is 562 and W in O is 184. Share in net assets. Share capital we already have after bonus 320 and 80. Pre-acquisition reserves 240, 96.8. $560 and $176.8. We get some goodwill, 2, 7.2. Check somewhere you say goodwill is written off. Point number E, goodwill in respect of H is written off. H goodwill is 2. Guys, when you're taking the share capital as 320, I'm taking even the pre-acquisition reserves as post-bonus reserves. If I take this as 160, then I need to take the reserves post-pre-bonus. So pre-bonus share capital, pre-bonus reserves. Now I took post-bonus share capital, post-bonus reserve. We picked up this 320, guys. If you would have picked up 160, then the share capital would have been pre-bonus. But my pre-acquisition reserves, I already deducted bonus. So it will be post-bonus pre-acquisition reserves. That can't be possible. Both should be same. I took post-bonus in both cases, share capital as well as reserves. Go for the minority interest. Minority share in net assets indicated by share capital and reserves. Minority share capital post bonus is 80. Minority share in the reserves are 60 and 64. I won't stop there. An addition should also be there for dividend. Dividend receivable. Minority share of dividend. The total dividend from the subsidiary is 30, out of which his share is 20%. 6. Total is 210. Don't forget this. If the dividend is paid, I wouldn't have added. But the dividend is payable, so compulsory I have to add. Carrying cost of investment in associate O. Start with his share in net assets. Share in net assets given in the form of share capital and pre-acquisition reserves. Share capital is 80. Reserve is 96.8 pre-acquisition reserve. My total share in net assets is 176.8. Add goodwill to this figure, we get cost of acquisition, sorry, cost of investment, 7.2 goodwill. Cost of investment is 184. Add his share in post-acquisition reserves, of associate O, 88.4. Check the distribution table, pick up the figure. One more addition is left out, dividend receivable. Post-acquisition dividend receivable from O. O proposed a dividend of 15. My share out of this is 40%. That is 6. So my carrying cost of investment is 278.4. check your reserves for CBS then. Reserves for consolidated balance sheet. I will start with W Limited balance. As on balance of reserves is 1050 plus a share in post acquisition reserves of H and in O. Share in post acquisition reserves of H 256 and in O 88.4. Don't forget to add dividend receivables. H and O. H proposes a dividend of 30, your share is 80%, 24, O proposed a dividend of 15, your share is 40%, 6, goodwill written off. Cost of control, I have written off goodwill worth 2. Last adjustment is his proposed dividend. He proposed a dividend check. Dividend proposed by W is 65. And that will be the balance of reserves for CBS. This is 1357.4. Information sufficient to prepare the balance sheet. Go for the consolidated balance sheet. Yes guys, let's draft the balance sheet. Equity and liabilities. Shareholder funds. Share capital. Only the holding company share capital, that is W's share capital, is 600. Reserves and surplus. Reserves for CBS 1357.4. Minority interest 210. Non-current liabilities, debentures, non-current liabilities, we have debentures, we need to add for the holding as in a subsidiary, O is an associate, no line by line addition, full consolidation for 375 plus, no one second, that's trade payables. Debentures are 400 and 150, that is 550. Current liabilities. Trade payables. As well as proposed dividend. Proposed dividend is 65. Trade payables. Trade payables is 375 plus 253. The total is 628. Assets. Non-current assets, tangible fixed assets, check tangible fixed assets 697 plus 648, that is 1345. I will not write intangible asset because goodwill is already written off. The 7.2 goodwill is associate goodwill. I will not take it in the balance sheet. I'll have other non-current assets, investments, carrying cost of investment in O. We already calculated that as 278.4. And finally, the current assets. Check the value of current assets. I have three current assets, cash, trade receivables and inventory. Cash. Straightforward in one single figure 101. Trade receivables. One second, guys. 101 plus 95 196 this is. Trade receivables is 386 plus 321, that is 707. Inventory 495 plus 389, that is 885 or 884, I guess. That is 884. That's it. The balance sheet should tally then. It's 3410.4 balance sheet total.